Before opening the WebHMI, there are some configuration steps that must be taken in several locations. To begin, I already have a project created, compiled, and configured to run the legacy client. Our first options are here in Studio. We must set a parameter in the parameters database called Citapi remote equals 1. This parameter enables external applications to access runtime. I will set that now and save the database. You may also set this option in the Citect.ini, but I'm not concerned with that now. Next, we configure our encryption settings. I cover this process elsewhere, but to recap, I have set the network address in the database to the host name of my server machine. This will generate a compiler warning if not done, so watch your compile messages at the bottom of the screen. In the configurator, access from the deployment page, I've configured this machine properly as a system management server. I could also connect to an existing server. For our purposes, the important component is that the certificates are being managed. At this point, I can start my project. And finally, I open the Application Configuration utility. Under Application Services, Citect Data Platform, I need to ensure that my current server address is set and the username and password are valid in my project. This enables a Windows service called Core Service Host to connect to that Citapi, which we just opened, and provide data to external applications like WebHMI, Basic Reports, and LiveView. This AOL user is created as part of the default project, but you may have changed this. If you make any changes to this dialog, be sure you restart the services. And when configured, click Test Citect Credentials. This test must pass successfully. If it fails, the WebHMI will not be able to log in. Finally, we can navigate to the address http://yourservername/webhmi. If all goes well, we can log in with a valid username and password and access the WebHMI. There aren't any diagrams yet, but we can access the other applications in the menu to diagnose and commission our system. In the next video, we will create our own first simple diagram. Until then, thank you.